Namaste to everyone. We're back again here for another episode of Corporate Insight. So what is it that we want to know? This is all about technology. We heard about what COVID has done, how is it affected to the people, corporates, as well as the travelers out there. So we are back here to discuss, preview from the people that what can technology do? How can technology support at the times like this? So today with us, we have a well-known person with us, Geeta Arikal. So a dear friend, and I think we have had the most laughs in all the sessions. And she is one person whom I know who is so outspoken and gives a straight from heart talk. So I think with much ado, we have Geeta with us from Siemens, heads the mobility and the supply management. She takes care of that entire for Siemens. So right now I'm handing over this to Geeta. Geeta, over to you. Could you quickly tell us how your journey has been? What is it that makes you tick? A little bit about your personal insight, which the other people don't know about. And that's something which they would like to know more about you. Over to you, Geeta.
Thank you, and namaste to all of those who are listening to me. And I really appreciate these efforts from you as well as DOPE. It's a great initiative. I have to say that it is keeping the industry alive. Great job there, guys. I really appreciate that. So, Jyoti, as always, it's always fun to connect with you offline, you. Online, right. And wherever we meet, we have always had the fun time of our life. And I cannot give away that. And hopefully I meet you personally. That's what I would say. Soon, and the situation would prevail for soon. I'm pretty seasoned in this industry, I would say it. Why I would say it? Because of 27 years of experience already, I'm into this industry. And right now, I feel that, okay, you give me anything, I can start, I can manage. That's the mode I am in. On a serious note, my working has been with managing the projects, facility, HR, administration, travel, procurement, security and risk. You ask all that, which I have knowledge of it. That is what has made me, like, you know, maybe in the 7 jobs, whatever I have changed, and the companies what I have worked have really added a lot of value for me. Just I have to take some names, like Vintage Foods was a basic which literally put the foundation for me, and then I moved to Fidelity, from there Northern Trust, and then Unilever, and of course now Siemens. And whatever I am today, I owe it to all these companies, because they've added one or the other way what I am today. They have made me a person who can, you know, strongly do things, say things, and make it success, and see those challenges as an opportunity. That's what I am totally as a person, professionally, if you ask me.
Okay, so a little insight about your personal life.
What people didn't know, or maybe knowing me, is I'm a baseball player. I played for the country. I'm a sports person. There is no sports which I haven't touched at the district level or the state level. I've done it. And yes, I wanted to be a veterinary doctor, but then landed in the travel industry. And I love traveling, and I love, farming. I do organic farming even now. And I love, mentoring people, of course. And I'm passionate about whatever I do. Even a little small thing I take it, I'm very passionate. I love gardening, and I love animals. And I started a new passion in the COVID time is baking.
Okay, so Geeta, it was nice knowing. So it's good to hear from our viewers' point of it. I think they would love to hear this inside of yours, because I also didn't know you were a baseball player, though I've known you for some years now. So interesting. So that's there, a sports person among us. So next time we have a sports activity in the travel, we know whom to reach out to. Other than panel discussion, I said, Geeta, now I need you for the active sports. Please come on.
Yeah, all with you. Yeah.
So with this, as we have gone through the space, which has been not a very comfortable space in our lives in the last couple of months, so there's been a lot of challenges. So technology is one thing which has kept us going to a certain extent. So with this, and especially with your vivid background and your exposure and other things, I just wanted to check with you, what in your view is the way forward for the travel industry, especially from the technology for the progress? So could you just give us a small insight on where do you think our technology will take us to the next level?
Thank you, Jyoti. That's a very good question, and a valid question, pertinent question at this situation. I do agree with your point that yes, it is pretty hardship what everybody of us are going in the industry. It's not only limited to corporates or only the travel suppliers, but everyone together, right? In this condition, technology, yes, that is the connecting love. Now, see the way we are connected. We are e-connected or virtually connected. This is a technology, right? Technology makes life simpler and easier, right? Mm-hmm. Now, if you look at the subject, you're saying that embracing of technology, that mm-hmm. is in India, I see it as a, taboo still. Okay, many big corporates are looking into it because they have been given to understand with a team like us, like, you know, saying this is interesting, this is where we save money. We drive it in a different way to let them know this is possible and we can do it, right? Mm-hmm. But not all companies who are in the travel, they are medium-sized companies and small companies, they are not looking into technology. What is that they are looking? Okay, seriously, they are looking into the quality service, right? Now, when we say the suppliers providing technology, is that covering the quality service? Then you can attend even to the medium size and segment as well as the lower segment companies too. That is where I see it. Technology is the way to go. And of course, you know, it enables you to do your normal work or a repeated work in a much better way, without errors or with less errors, I would say it. For that, we need the suppliers. At the same time, the investment on both sides, be it from the corporate, be it from the supplier, has to be, equivocal. And they have to talk about, yes, we need this technology and we need to go through this. This is the way to perform. That I don't see it yet. And of course, when we are talking, the suppliers per se, I'm talking more about, when we talk to the corporates, we need to understand what the corporate needs. Technology cannot be one solution for everyone. It's a different, you have to customize it and provide it. So you need to understand the need of a customer. That is something which I feel it is lacking in the industry. They are keeping that nascent steps towards it. And also the second thing what I see is every solution is provided as a scattered way. It's a piecemeal. It's not like end-to-end solution by one agency. You know, that's the challenge I see it. Because if I have to go to one supplier, they would give me, say, example X. And I have to go for the other one to take my Y and Z. Is that the way it should work? And then it becomes a challenge to move around and say, you know what, I need this and this person and I have to have multiple companies rather than I'll go through the manual way. Okay, that's where it is taking a trouble. And the piecemeal, what I have a solution maybe is when I'm talking about this challenge, I won't even touch about the solution. Can these piecemeals providing agencies, can they collaborate? All these energies, can they work together and provide a single solution end to end? Like take that GST today, so many are addressing it in a different way. There is nothing like end to end. Right? If that can be done, I think it will be, adoption is so quick. Even if you have to spend a little more money, people would be ready to do it if there is a solution, if they don't have to go for multiple agencies.
So Geeta, as you said, that was very well said. And now we would like to know your view from on the AI. There's a lot of talks about AI, data mining, bots and other things. So we want to understand if the travel industry is ready to accept this, especially in from your travel corporate buyers, where you have the CEOs and the CFOs and the top level traveling who have been on a very high touch. Even if small thing goes wrong, they pick up the phone and say, can this be corrected? What is it to be done? And we have handheld them till now. So that has to change going further. So do you think these things will help and will they embrace it?
Thank you, Jyoti. It's a very valid question and a beautiful question, I must say. I would say all these questions, whatever you said, AI, data mining, bots, you know, it's something like which has created a confusion. And I'm sure successfully confused all our travel hankos too, if I have to respond to you cheekily. And having said that, these are great options, okay? Mm-hmm. And they are great support for the industry and the growth, right? Mm-hmm. These are very much needed. Yes, as you said, CEOs and CFOs, not only that, even today, the travel managers or anybody, they are talking about this. They are all towards it because they know how life becomes easier and to achieve their goal, how it directs you. Okay, it literally travels you from one level to the other, and the levels are just evolving. Okay, mm-hmm. Yes, these are there, and this is there not in a very, what do you say, experienced or a much better ways. There could be, it can be improved. That's the level it is in today, and hence people are now testing it. Okay, they're testing the waters right now, and yes, there are some people that are preferring to do it, but comfort level of your customer, what matters here. The comfortness what the customer has is in approaching a person and talking to him, you know, rather than having a chat bot talking to them. But if you look at the millennials or the younger generation, they do not want to deal with people. If you see that, right, they want an answer and a quick one and on the move, right? If for that, I'm sure this is going to be the way forward in the future. Your bot will be talking more than human beings, of course. But data is something I think my generation and maybe the CEOs and CFOs levels, they would surely look into it, because it gives you a way to analyze and evaluate what is happening today and take what are those steps you need to do it for the future growth. If you are looking at from a top, you need to look at a data where you want to correct and how you want to write or how you want to deal or how you want to take forward. Maybe that is a guidance. It is required. These are very, very important tools today. And it's going to be more dependable in the coming years. That is what I would say.
That's interesting. I think that's out there to all the suppliers and the partners who work with them. There's a message. So yes, you can streamline your processes, work with the right kind of solutions, and that would be a success. That's a message we see here. So with this, I would also like Verily, you said data mining is an important part, and that's it. So in a nutshell, if you could tell me, how can data be used to sustain yourself and also act as a projection for it? What would be that one nutshell message you would like to give to our viewers?
You know, data, yes, we spoke about it, is very, very important. But I would like to all of us to follow a caution here. Tread the solution with a lot of caution, because what you're asking, okay, you might have heap on your lap and you don't know what to do with it. That may be the condition if you ask for a data without knowing what you want.
True.
So what I would say, maybe the first step, you should be looking at data design as a subject for all the travel managers.
Wow, that's interesting.
Yeah, that's something which I haven't seen, which we all try to do. Okay, we sit with the PMCs and others saying that, okay, this is what I want. And they say, okay, this is what I have. We try to deal with what they have. Mm-hmm. Rather, I would say each company requirements is totally different today, right? So if I have to see it, maybe I would bifurcate further, saying that maybe some people need to do it only the data for alerting the management, okay? Or maybe alerting the travelers, or maybe alerting the commercial, okay? Or maybe to alert the compliance, or maybe drive only the sales, or maybe only process improvement. So, I mean, what the data available today, the customized, uncustomized data and whatever somebody is selling, is just like a presentation, whatever is happening end to end. Like, it's like a heap. But if you don't want to lose the credentials and the data, the worthiness, then you need to know what you want to have. So maybe that 4 to 5 points, what matters to you most for your company or for your program, that is what you should design and that is what you should concentrate on. That's what I call it as data design. And all of us need to take that subject seriously and design our data what we want and only work with that. Plan with it. Today, transaction number doesn't matter. How much spend you do it doesn't matter. What is your behavior? What made that behavior happen? Maybe that root cause analysis is what we require in the data. For that, get your data to enable you to do the root cause analysis. That's what I would do in the data.
So now with this insight, I would also like to know that every new initiative that's coming up in the travel industry or anywhere, it's all on the apps and people are preferring to have an app-driven solution. So do you think apps are here to stay or apps are here just a fad? So can we have some small insight from you on this?
If at all you're looking at an app, okay, I use my app. And when you look at that, is there a way we can address the need of the younger generation, then app is the way to go. Because if you're moving and if you want a quick, like say for example, you're sitting in a metro and you want to book a ticket, That's the app. Or you want to book a car, there is an app. Or you want to pay for somebody, there is an app. Today, you don't have to sit in front of your system. Most of the time, I do it. By that, I'm not anyway claiming that I'm young, though my age, I always feel that it has stopped after 25.
Yeah. All of us.
Okay. Cheers to 25. So, people in the fast moving. Yes. If you are lazy, laid back, yes, buddy, you take the web portal, sit and access, log in, all that happens. Otherwise, you are downloaded. You can see the difference. You have downloaded an app and you, feed in all your data and get the things done. That is a pretty faster. I would say that is the way to go forward. Any solution providers or any suppliers in the market, I have only one suggestion or I would urge them to do is, whenever you're coming with any technical solution, make sure you have an app support to it.
On the technology front to the newcomers, as well as the people who needs to adapt something, what is it that you would like to say in one line to them?
Technology is something to make your life simpler, okay? Mm-hmm. So where is it you find it difficult today? That's where you need to have a technology solution, right? Or if at all you're doing a stressful, repetitive job, make sure that is the smaller way to start your technology. Take your technology, and those are very simple and less expensive too. Have invest in technology to see that how effective you can get. It is a growth of a company along with the travel managers, that's what I would say. So looking at every problem with a solution has to be a technology. That is when I think we can deliver the best. And I have seen that even in all my roles, wherever we have seen the problems, we've always come with a solution. That is going to be a technology. Rather than using people, I would use people have better brains, better knowledge. Technology does what you want. So rather than using their creativity to do what you want, I would use them to do certain good things and use the technology to do what I want. That's the difference, I would say.
That's interesting. So thank you so much, Geeta. It has been really nice of you to spend this. And I think it's one of the very a good insight to what's happening on the technology side. And I'm out there. I'm sure the viewers will really enjoy it. So with this, I would like to take a sign off, thanking you from the Dope team, as well as from me personally. Lovely talking to you as always. And it's always keeps our minds active. Because you don't just say the things, it is there is proven things that you have given us. It has helped. Thank you so much for it. And looking forward to seeing you soon today. And there, viewers, please watch. There's a lot of insight which comes to you. And keep looking at for more episodes to come in. Looking forward to hearing from you. The Dope team, thank you.